Last month, at the rally of Peace Now, Tel Aviv, Dan Almagor, one of the leading entertainers of Israel, got up and said the following words: We had better prepare the glass cages in which we will sit when they put us on trial for what we have done to the Palestinians. What an obscenity! What an outrage! What a sick human being this is! The comparison to an Eichmann, to Nazis, what a sickness this person is! And for all the Jews of Israel who are upset and said, how can you compare Jews to Nazis? That is how God punishes people who sat by quietly when they compared us to Nazis and were silent. God repays measure for measure. What, how obscene it was to call the Koch movement Nazis. But who protested? Who said no? No one said no. They were repaid measure for measure. Suddenly, Jews got up and called the army of Israel a Nazi army. What an obscenity, what a sickness. And how, unless we do something about this to end this, God forbid, there will be no Israel left. A country which is moving towards civil war. Do you know how many Jews refuse to serve beyond the Green Line? We only hear either of people who are well known or people who want their case known. But the hundreds of others, anonymous people, faceless people, who come every day and say, I will not serve beyond the Green Line. And the army says, it's Beseder Gamur, you serve in Sfat. It's better not to have problems. Let's keep this thing quiet. What we are seeing is the Vietnamization of Israel. But if in the Vietnam War, if the left was wrong, it was a mistake that was 8,000 miles away. If the left is wrong today in Israel about the territories, it is a tragedy that will sweep away Israel too. They're destroying our young people. As it is, the secular Sabra doesn't know who he is, what he is, and where he is, and why he is. As it is, he's a miskin, a nebuch. No identity, just who he is. That's in the best of times. And now, on top of that, they take this poor fellow and tell him, you're a Nazi. You kill children. Yesh Gvul, another group, there is a limit. There's a limit. Believe me, there is a limit. There's a limit. Hands out to all soldiers a booklet telling them how not to serve. This is what's happening today. We are poisoning the souls of our youth, feeding them guilt and self-hate. It is a corrosive thing. It eats away their soul. For 40 years, Israel survived a tiny state in the midst of all these lions. It survived because it was certain that it was right. It was certain of the justice of its cause. And for the first time now, the justice of its cause is being questioned by other Jews. You cannot have an army fighting properly, with strength, courage, if it is convinced that it is really wrong. And on top of everything else, they take a soldier, give him a gun, send him to Gaza, and then tell them you can't use the gun. There's a trial taking place now. Four soldiers in the crack units of Givat. They killed an Arab. They killed an Arab. They're on trial now because it's true that he threw rocks and he threw stones at them and seriously wounded one. But since he was running away, the act had ended, and therefore you can't kill him. This is the kind of convoluted thinking, polluted thinking, which puts Jews into prison and sends soldiers into a frustration. If I don't shoot, I may be killed. If I do shoot, I may go to jail. So the best thing is to back away slowly. And that's what the Arabs see. Soldiers backing away from them. That's what they see. And that's their courage then. And this gives them confidence. And this makes soldiers sick and tired of being there.